Mary McDermott and Mike Gibson coming to you live from AHA 2025, and we're talking about the use of metformin in peripheral arterial disease. Mary, what did you do and what did you find?
So we studied whether metformin could improve walking performance in people with peripheral artery disease who do not have diabetes. Participants were randomized in a double-blind fashion to either metformin or placebo for 6 months. At 6 months follow-up, we found that metformin did not significantly improve 6-minute walk compared to placebo. Both groups declined by about 5 meters. So we also found that there were no effects of metformin on any of our secondary or exploratory outcomes. So our conclusion was that metformin did not significantly improve 6-minute walk in people with peripheral artery disease who do not have diabetes.
And what was the pathophysiologic basis to think that it might have improved things?
Well, metformin is commonly thought of as an anti-aging medication, and it has effects that include activating AMP kinase that stimulates mitochondrial activity. It also can increase eNOS activity to improve perfusion. PAD patients have mitochondrial impairment, and they have, of course, perfusion difficulty. So metformin, based on its pleiotropic effects, could have been was reasonably thought to perhaps improve walking performance in peripheral artery disease.
Well, another great hypothesis, Mary, kind of shot down by the data yet again, but that's why we do trials, right?
That's correct.
Great. Mary, thank you. Thanks for sharing, and thanks for joining us here live from AHA 2025.
Thank you so much for having me.